Hi students, today we discuss about organoaluminium compounds. The topic name is organoaluminium compounds. Organoaluminium compounds. Organoaluminium compounds. In this, first we discuss about preparations. So first preparation, in this we take dimethyl mercury. CH3 2 H G, dimethyl mercury. So 3 moles dimethyl mercury react with 2 moles aluminium. In presence of 363 kelvins temperature we maintain, finally we get trimethyl aluminium. So 2 moles AlCH3 3. So this name trimethyl aluminium. So in this 3HG also. So this is the preparation of organoaluminium compound. The particular compound name is trimethyl aluminium. So trimethyl aluminium is an organoaluminium compound. So next preparation, 6 moles CH3MgCl. So RMgX. So simply Grignard reagent. So the compound name is methyl magnesium chloride. So this compound react with 3 moles aluminium chloride. So we get same trimethyl aluminium. Trimethyl aluminium. AlCH3 3. So next CH3 2 AlCl plus CH3 AlCl2 plus 6 MgCl2. So but our desired compound trimethyl aluminium. Next third preparation, very easy third one. In this we using aluminium 2 moles and it react with methyl iodide 3 moles methyl iodide. In presence of, we maintain at 443 kelvins temperature we maintain, finally we get trimethyl aluminium. So this is the preparation of trimethyl aluminium. So this is the organoaluminium compound. Next we discuss about properties. So in this first one, trimethyl aluminium react with 3 moles H2O. Means trimethyl aluminium react with water simply. Finally we get methane, 3 moles methane. And AlOH3. But our desired compound methane. Next second one, trimethyl aluminium. We take trimethyl aluminium. So it react with 3 moles HCl. Finally we get methane. Finally, we get methane. Next product, aluminium chloride. Aluminium chloride. Next, third one. Trimethyl aluminium react with ether. React with ether. Finally, we get adduct. Finally, we get adduct. So, this is C2H5 2O Al CH3 3. So this is the adduct. This is the adduct. Next we go for bond nature and structure. Bond nature and structure. Bond nature and structure. So first we discuss about structure. So Al CH3 CH3 CH3. Next Al CH3 CH3 CH3. So this name trimethyl aluminium. So in this structure two aluminiums are there. So it is a dimer. It is a dimer in gaseous or solid state. Al aluminium present between two methyl groups. Two methyl groups. So the bond are bridge bond. The bond is bridge bond. So in this aluminium shows sp3 hybridization. Aluminium shows sp3 hybridization. sp3 hybridization. So next uses. So what is the use of trimethyl aluminium? So basically alkyl aluminium compound means alkyl. So CH3, C2H5, those all are alkyls. So alkyl aluminium compound useful for polymerization of alkene. Polymerization of alkene. Basically alkyl aluminium compounds useful for polymerization of alkene. So the compound Al C2H5 3 plus TiCl4. So this is the Ziegler-Natta catalyst. Ziegler-Natta catalyst. Ziegler-Natta catalyst. So this is the use. Once again I tell, alkyl aluminium compounds useful for polymerization of alkene. Polymerization of alkene. So example, so this compound name is Ziegler-Natta catalyst. It useful for polymerization of alkenes. Polymerization of alkene. So those all are we discuss about trimethyl aluminium. So this is the first one. So trimethyl aluminium. So next we discuss about another. Second one, triphenyl aluminium. Triphenyl aluminium. Triphenyl aluminium. C6H5 3 Al. Triphenyl aluminium. So this is also organo aluminium compound. This is also organo aluminium compound. So previous we discuss alkyl aluminium compound. In this we discuss about phenyl aluminium compound. So first preparation of triphenyl aluminium. So first preparation. Preparations. In this first one, aluminium react with diphenyl mercury C6H5 2 Hg. So this is the diphenyl mercury. So finally we get triphenyl aluminium. Name triphenyl aluminium. Next, second preparation. So in this we take C6H5 MgCl. So it react with aluminium chloride AlCl3. So finally we get triphenyl aluminium. So our desired compound triphenyl aluminium, and we get C6H5 2 AlCl. At the same time C6H5 AlCl2. So this is also one kind of preparation of triphenyl aluminium. Third one. So in this 3 moles Hg C6H5 2. So diphenyl mercury. It react with aluminium. So we get Al2 C6H5 6. So this compound name is hexaphenyl dialane. And next 3 moles Hg mercury. So fourth preparation and last one. In this phenyl lithium we take C6H5 6 moles. So it react with Al2Cl6. So finally we get Al2C6H5 6. Same hexaphenyl dialane formed. So in next 6 moles lithium chloride is there. So this is overall preparation of triphenyl aluminium. This is the organo aluminium compound. Next we discuss about properties. So in this majorly we discuss, so this compound colorless and volatile solid, colorless and volatile solid. And this compound freezing point 503. Freezing point 503 kelvins. It is a dimer in crystal state. And it is easily dissolving benzene. And the compound oxidized with air, but compared to alkyl compound shows less reactivity. So this is the properties of triphenyl aluminium. So first one, trimethyl aluminium. So this is the triphenyl aluminium. This is overall organo aluminium compounds. Thank you.